conclude this demonstration now with the introduction of Dr. Hilbro, space scientist and inventor of the Athena. Dr. Hilbro.
Fellow cosmonauts, the Athena spacecraft is now completely tested. The entire universe is now open to us.
Yes, gentlemen.
What man? Do you hear, Azo?
I hear, Great Cradnook.
The Earth Moon Man is speaking strong words.
He is, Great Cradnook.
Would you like a closer look at the Athena spacecraft, Azo?
That would be interesting indeed, Great One.
And how about a little talk with Dr. Hilbro?
That would be most interesting.
Perhaps it is time. Azo, call a meeting of the Grand Council.
Immediately, Great Cradnook.
We move at once.
Two two zero seven four four six. Roger, out. Well, Randy, we're approaching moon. Right, Mr. Navigator?
That's right, Captain Flynn. We'll be in Mare Imbrium in a very few minutes now.
Wow, and it's not even 5 hours since we left Earth. The trip sure went fast.
All systems A-OK 206. Touchdown at 4:33. Over.
Roger, out.
Was that the robot at the spaceport, Captain Flynn?
It sure was, Randy.
Boy, would I like to be an astronaut and have a ship like this.
If you like this one, wait until you see your friend Dr. Hilbro's new interstellar spaceship, the Athena.
It's the most advanced ever built, isn't it?
And then some. Its cruising speed is 100,000 miles an hour, and it's all ready to go. Dr. Hilbro broadcast the news last night.
Wow!
Now Dr. Hilbro will be able to travel millions and millions of miles out in space and go to planets no one's ever been to, or maybe even heard of before.
Do you think there are people, beings like us, on any of the planets out there?
It's possible.
I wonder if they'll be friendly, or be enemies.
Well, I'm afraid we won't know about that until we meet them.
If anybody ever does meet them, I bet it will be Dr. Hilbro.
I guess you're right, Randy. You know, you're mighty lucky his son, Hagor, is your friend.
I'll say. Otherwise, I couldn't even have come on this trip to the moon.
We're banking for touchdown now, Randy. Look over here. I'll show you the spaceport.
Where?
It's that big gray and red striped dome on the left. See it?
Oh, yes. And look at all the other different colored domes.
You'll stay with Hagor in one of the blue ones. They're the homes.
There's so many.
Sure. Mare Imbrium is a big science complex. Over 8,000 people live here.
Randy, I think you'd better get back to your seat now. We're touching down, and you don't want to be late getting off. Hager and Dr. Hilbro will be looking for you.
All right, Captain Flynn. Thanks for letting me ride up here in flight control with you, Navigator Bill. It was great.
We were glad to have you, Randy.
Any friend of Dr. Hilbro is a friend of ours. Right, Captain?
Right. Well, so long, Randy.
Yeah, goodbye,
bye,
Randy.
Bye.
Attention, please, Mare Imbrium. Please use the exit on the port side. Passengers may be fitted for their spacesuits on the lower level of the spaceport capsule.
Hi, Miss Adams.
Oh, there you are, Randy. Better hurry. We've landed.
We sure did set down easy.
Don't forget anything, Randy.
Oh, look, here's your star chart.
Oh, thanks. I'm going to ask Dr. Hilbro if he'll mark the Athena's next mission on it for me.
Randy, there are your friends. See them?
Yes, that's Hagor!
And Dr. Hilbro.
And that's Hagor's sister Judy with them. Hagor! Hagor!
Greetings, Randy!
Goodbye, Miss Adams.
Goodbye, Randy. Have a good visit.
I will!
Hello, Randy. You're right on time.
Hi, Hagor. How do you do, Dr.
Hello,
Hilbro?
Randy.
Hi, Judy.
Nice to have you, Randy. Did you have a good trip?
It was great. Captain Flynn and Navigator Bill let me ride most of the way up front with them.
Flight Alpha 7 departing for London, Continental Spacedrome at 314-23. Passengers now loading at panel 0032.
Did you hear that, Randy? That was moon time. The 14th hour, 23rd minute of the third section of the day.
I'll never get used to that. It's so different.
You'll have a lot of new things to get used to out here.
Like, our days are 2 weeks long.
And so are the nights.
And there's no noise outside.
Because there's no atmosphere.
Not so fast, children. You'll have time to acquaint Randy with all the differences between Moon and Earth later. Right now, I suggest we get over to the Athena Control Center to pick up Randy's spacesuit and jetpack.
While we're there, Dad, may we show Randy the Athena? Inside, I mean.
That's Dad's new spaceship. It's in the spaceport next to this one.
Oh, could I see it?
Well, we shouldn't take the time now.
Oh, please, Dad. We'll be right there.
Well, maybe for just a minute. But we mustn't take long. You know your mother's expecting us.
Oh, thank you, Dr. Hillbro. That'll be great.
Come on, Randy. The control room and the Athena are just through this passageway.
We got your spacesuit and jetpack ahead of time so you wouldn't have to stand in line.
We left them at Athena Control with ours.
Oh, good.
However, Randy, you won't need your spacesuit inside any of the bubble domes. Gravity and air pressure are neutralized there. It's just like being on Earth.
It really is?
We go through here. There she is. That's the Athena.
Ooh, she's terrific. Different from any spacecraft I've ever seen.
It's a new design.
Cosmonauts call it the FN for Flying Needle because it's so long and thin.
This is the Athena Ground Control Center, Randy.
Wow, there's so many controls.
Look at this, Randy. This is the remote entry hatch release. Watch the Athena while I turn it on.
The hatch is opening. And a moving tread is coming down.
Come on, we'll show you the Athena inside, okay, Dad?
All right. Take your suits and jetpacks and come along.
Dr. Hillbro, calling Dr. Hillbro.
Now hold it, Hagar. That's Newcomb, my stratistician, calling me.
Can we go inside without you, Dad, if we promise not to touch anything?
Oh, very well. I'll be there as soon as I can.
Thanks, Dad. Okay, Randy. Here we go.
Oh, I like this moving staircase. It's so smooth.
Isn't it fun?
It works on a laser beam. Well, here we are.
This is the Astrolab.
Oh, boy. Someday I'm going to fly a ship like this.
What was that?
I don't know. That's funny. The hatch closed.
Maybe your father closed it with the remote.
He wouldn't do that.
But look, the spaceport panels are opening.
I think we're moving.
Well, that's impossible.
But I feel it.
Judy's right, Hagar. Look at the control panel. Should it be all lit up like that?
No, it shouldn't. Something very strange is going on.
Oh, do something, Hagar. Please do something.
Don't be afraid, Judy. I'll get Dad on the telex. Attention, Mare Imbrium. Calling Athena Control. This is the spacecraft Athena calling Athena Control. That's odd. The telex is blanked out. There must be some sort of disturbance.
Hagar, the moon is disappearing behind us. And look at that dial. Isn't that the velocity indicator?
Yes.
It's all the way over to the limit.
Hello, Athena Control. Calling Dr. Hillbro. Dad, Dad. It's no use. Something has thrown the telex out. I'll try the solar comm. It works by sun energy. Nothing can go wrong with that. Calling Mare Imbrium Control. This is the Athena spacecraft.
They can't hear us.
Now, don't be frightened, Judy. We'll make contact.
Hello? Hello?
Hillbro speaking.
Dad, Dad.
Daddy, help us.
Hagar, Judy, what's happening? What have you done?
There's something strange, Dad. I can't
Hagar,
see it.
Hagar, do you remember what controls you touched?
We didn't touch anything at all.
We don't know how we got started, Dad.
Oh, what shall we do? Dad! Dad! I lost him.
He's gone.
Hagar, did you see the spaceometer? It says we've gone 53,000 miles, and we've only been moving a couple of minutes.
Oh, I've got to get through to Dad again. Mare Imbrium, calling Mare Imbrium. This is the Athena spaceship. Please come in.
Look at the spaceometer. It's turning over like lightning. 58,000, 71,000, 85,000.
But no spaceship goes that fast. Why, that would approach the speed of light.
The speed of light?
All our scientists together have never been able to achieve that. I've got to get through to control. Hello? Hello, Mare Imbrium calling Dr. Hillbro at Athena Control. Dad, are you there? absolutely nothing on the solar comet's never failed before.
What are we gonna do?
Someone must have touched off the remote send-off. There's no other explanation except...
Except what?
There was an odd sound when we started moving, like nothing I've ever heard before.
According to the spaceometer, we've already gone 500,000 miles.
Try this solar comet again, Hagar, please.
I will, Judy. It's just gotta work. Hello? Mare Imbrium Control, come in, please.
We may as well give up, Hagar. We'll never get through to Mare Imbrium now. We'd better try to get our bearings. Can you tell where we're heading?
The computer can. According to the altigraph, our flight path is 14.376 degrees, 13 minutes. And according to the spaceometer, we've gone over 200 million miles. Here's the reading. Our trajectory is in line with the constellation of Centaur. Alpha Centauri is the nearest star to our own sun. Of course, something could change our flight path.
What could do that?
Well, some strange force must be controlling this ship. It could be taking us somewhere we don't even know about.
Are there any other possibilities besides Alpha Centauri?
Yes, there are certain asteroids or planetoids. My father was intending to explore the largest on his next trip.
Could this power be coming from there? From people like us?
Maybe not exactly like us, but intelligent beings.
Hey, Cora, I'm scared.
Judy, we'll be all right. But I've been thinking, we should be prepared for trouble. If there are people on some planet or planetoid, and they're taking us there, they might not be friendly. We should have a danger signal. Something we could say that would mean... Watch out.
That's a good idea, Randy.
But what could it be?
How about Hajra? That's the first two letters of your name, then Judy's, then mine. It could mean warning danger. Hajra.
That's good. Hajra. Hajra.
And it's easy to remember. Hajra.
Of course we have a hypno gun. See, it's hidden here behind this panel.
What does it do?
It shoots a ray that immobilizes a person's arms and legs temporarily.
That could come in handy. But...
Hajra! Hajra! The computer is changing its calculations.
And look at the electromagnetic oscillator.
What does it mean?
We've moved into a magnetic field of minus 2G. We're in a capture orbit.
There's a planet on the telescanner.
We're changing speed. We're heading straight for touchdown.
Look! You can see green stuff and water.
And strange-looking buildings.
We're coming down. We're coming down.
Well, we landed okay. Now what?
Listen.
People.
But who? Hajra, the hatch is opening.
Do you see? What strange creatures.
They're sort of purple.
And they have four arms and four hands. They're so tall, and they have no necks.
I hope they're friendly.
Do you think we should get the hypno gun?
No, better not. They're more apt to be friendly if we're unarmed. I'm going to speak to them. Greetings. We've come from Earth's moon. Can you tell us where we've landed?
They don't understand you.
Make way for the Supreme Shakur. Make way.
Shaka Shakur. Shaka Shakur.
That must be the head man.
The other one said make way in English.
That's funny.
Greetings, my young friends. Welcome to Cronus.
Cronus? Is that in our solar system?
I never heard of it.
Oh, thank you. May we ask to whom we are speaking?
I am Cradnok, Grand Shakul of Cronus. Come out of your spaceship. Do not be afraid.
Come on, Judy. Hagar, we better do what he says.
Let's keep together.
You may come out too, Dr. Hillbro.
Dr. Hillbro? That's my father.
Certainly, I know all about Dr. Hillbro. Come out, Dr. Hillbro.
But he's not here.
Do not try to deceive the great Kradnook. Tell him to come out at once.
But Hagar is speaking the truth, Mr. Kradnook. Dr. Hillbro is still on the moon.
Hazel, search the spaceship at once.
Yes, Grand Shakur.
Sir, Dr. Hillbro is not here. Just we three were in the spacecraft when it left Earth's moon.
Do you think I'm interested in you? It is Dr. Hillbro I must have. Him, as well as his diabolical spaceship with which he intends to lead his invasion of Cronus.
Is that what you think?
It is what I know.
The children tell the truth, Grand Shakur. Dr. Hillbro is not there.
Impossible. How dare you come without Dr. Hillbro, you three children?
But, sir, we were brought here against our will. We would be very happy if you would just send us back.
Silence! You are my hostages. You called Hagar. You are the son of Dr. Hillbro. You must know of Earth's plans to invade Cronus.
Oh, no, sir. Why, Earth doesn't even know of Cronus.
Don't lie to me. We have watched your preparations on Earth and its moon for many years. I will have the truth from you.
Sir, you must believe us. The men of Earth only want to learn about the universe.
We want to be friends with you.
Enough! I have heard enough. Azel, take them to the fifth detention. We will get the truth from them. Ingopen, upselling.
Haka, great Kratnik! Haka, Grand Shakur!
Follow me.
Yes, sir. But Mr. Kradnik must believe us. Earth never had thoughts of invading anybody.
Why, we didn't even know there was a planet Cronus until today.
The Grand Shakur will learn the truth. Here is the fifth detention. Now, you will stay here until the great Kradnook sends for you.
Well, we sure are in a mess.
I'll say.
And another mystery.
What do you mean, Randy?
How is it that Kradnook and Azo speak English, and the rest of the Cronus people don't?
Nobody else can understand us.
Kradnook can tell them anything he likes, even that we were trying to invade them.
They'll all be our enemies.
They must have some tremendous secret power to be able to get hold of the Athena and bring us here.
If they're so powerful, I don't see why they'd be afraid of an invasion by Earth.
Neither do I. We've got to find out what's really going on.
I don't know how we're going to learn their secret.
Did you notice the strange key Kradnook wears around his waist?
Yes.
It must be very important for him to keep it with him all the time.
That's true. It might be the answer to something.
And remember, Kradnook is going to ask us a lot of questions. If we're smarter than he is, maybe we can learn something from him.
Adjoel, what is it? There's someone outside the panel. Shh.
Well, my young friends, now we will have our little talk. Azel?
Yes, Grand Shakur.
Bring one of our Cronus Maldinas for each of our young friends.
Yes, Grand Shakur.
The Maldina is an exotic flower of rare perfume. It is our custom on Cronus to present a Maldina to visitors in an expression of friendship. You will each breathe deeply of its fragrance to signify that you return our friendship.
Here are the Maldinas, Shakur.
Good, Azel. Give one to each.
Oh, they're so nice.
Breathe deeply of them, please. Then we will proceed with our talk again. Now we shall hear the truth.
And only the truth, Shakul.
What preparations are being made on Earth's moon for an attack on Cronus? Tell me.
There are no preparations, sir.
You, the son of Dr. Hillbro, what do you know? Tell me.
Earth and its moon have no thought of invading any planet, sir.
The Maldina takes effect on these Earth people quickly, Grand Shakur.
Yes, Azo. I think they are a soft race. What is the purpose of Dr. Hillbro's space trips? Tell me.
He seeks knowledge of the universe, Shakur.
Does he know of our planet, Cronus? Tell me.
I do not know, Shakul.
Quiet. I wish the son of Dr. Hillbro to answer. Has Dr. Hillbro discovered the existence of the planet Cronus? Tell me.
No, Shakul.
Does Earth possess the element Soladium? Tell me.
I do not know of an element Soladium, Shakul.
It could be known on Earth by another name, Shakul.
True. Do you possess an element lighter than hydrogen? Tell me.
There is no element lighter than hydrogen, Shakul.
Do you possess an element capable of generating photon power? Tell me.
Photon power is not possible, sir.
It is as I thought. Earth does not possess Soladium. Come, Azo. Call the council an emergency session. Farewell, my young friends. You will not remember any part of this conversation when the Maldino wears off.
Farewell, Grand Shakul.
Hagor, Judy!
Yes, Randy?
It is as I suspected. The Maldino is a truth plant. It makes you tell the truth. Hagor, Judy, you must try to concentrate. Judy, Judy, come out of it. Listen to me. Listen carefully. I've learned the secret of the Cronus power.
Oh, Randy.
I suspected the Maldino was a truth plant and didn't breathe it. I learned that Cronus has an element they call Soladium. It's lighter than hydrogen, and it's capable of generating photon power.
Oh, Randy, you're so smart.
Oh,
Hagor is coming out of it.
Good, but I can't wait. Kradnuk has called a council meeting. I've got to find out where it is and see what more I can learn.
But you can't get out of here.
Yes, I can. I saw how Kradnuk opened the panel.
Randy, Judy...
Hurry, Judy. I'll show you how to open the panel. When I come back, I'll tap four times, like this. And you let me in.
Randy, Judy...
See this little triangle in the wall decoration? Pass your hand over it in a downward spiral. That activates the photoelectric cell.
It's open.
What are you doing,
Quick,
Randy?
Judy. Quick. Reverse the action to close panel. Explain to Hagor and listen for me to return.
Yes, Randy, but be careful.
Judy, where is Randy going?
Quiet, Hagor. I'll explain.
What's going on out there?
It sounds like some sort of demonstration. Oh, I hope they don't catch Randy.
I must help. I must go after him.
No, Hagor, we must wait here and let him in the instant he taps on the panel. It could be a matter of life and death.
Silence! His Supreme Shakul, Kradnuk of Cronus.
Oka, Kradnuk, Oka, Shakul.
Council members, I have called you in session to announce that our first step toward invasion of Earth has been successful. The Earth-Moon spaceship Athena has arrived as planned.
Oka, Kradnuk, Oka, Shakul.
Unfortunately, Dr. Hillbro is not aboard. However, council members, Dr. Hillbro's son was. He has been subjected to a truth interrogation. Council members, it is as I suspected. Earth does not have Soladium. Destruction of the Earth race is assured. After Earth, the entire galaxy. The Earthlings shall be interrogated further. We will learn everything necessary to the success of our plans. Full-scale invasion. 1,000 spaceships, each with an inexhaustible Dana death ray. That is all, council members. We attack in 3 days.
Hagor, I'm worried about Randy. He's been gone a long time. What if they've caught him?
I wish you hadn't let him go.
But I couldn't stop him.
If only I'd been fully conscious.
It's Randy! He's back!
Quick, Judy, let him in!
Randy!
We were
afraid they caught you.
Hurry, shut the panel, Judy.
You heard the meeting?
I sure did, and it's just as I suspected. Kradnik never thought Earth was planning to attack Cronus. The truth is, Cronus is going to attack Earth in 3 days.
Three days?
That's right. We've got to get back to Earth and warn them.
But how?
Did Judy tell you about Seladium?
Just that Cronus has it, whatever it is.
Well, it's the answer to everything. It's Seladium that made it possible for them to force the Athena to come here. And it's going to take Seladium to get us away.
Wow. It sure must be powerful.
And listen to this. They're going to attack Earth with 1,000 spacecraft, each with an inexhaustible Dana death ray. Now that they know Earth does not have Seladium, they are certain they can defeat us and become the rulers of the entire galaxy.
Then we have to find this Seladium.
Exactly.
Do you have a plan, Randy?
Well, listening to that meeting, I learned something. The men of Cronus are very sure of themselves and boastful. I'm going to see if I can get Kradnik or Azo to talk about Seladium and maybe reveal where they keep it.
It might work.
Anyway, it's worth a try.
Hadra!
Good evening, young friends. I have brought food.
Thank you, Azo. I'm awfully hungry.
Do you have Klingerts on Earth?
I don't think so.
What are they?
They are an animal. Very good. The meat is succulent when heat pressured.
Sounds great.
You have many things on Cronus that we don't have on Earth. But we have some that you don't have.
Nothing as good as we have.
We have great power. You laugh?
You Earthlings know nothing of power.
We have atomic power and nuclear power.
What is nuclear power?
It propels our spaceships. We use it for many things.
But we have Seladium. Seladium is the most powerful element in all the galaxies, and only we Cronians possess it.
How do you know you are the only ones?
We know. We know.
I don't see how you can be so sure.
Millions of Cronians have toiled for thousands of generations to extract it. It is so rare.
Have you ever seen it?
It is in a special room in the very center of the Dromo, guarded day and night. Only the great Kradnik can open the chamber with his magna key.
The key he wears around his waist.
Here, come eat this Klingert.
Hadra, I'm sorry, Mr. Azo. We can't eat until you leave.
You are to eat now, while I am here.
But we can't. It is our custom on Earth not to eat before strangers.
I know of no such custom. Very well. I will return. But eat it all, and quickly!
He's gone.
Why'd you tell him that?
I had to. This food may be another Mildina. We've got to get rid of it.
But I'm hungry.
I have some energy capsules. Here, Judy, take one. It's enough food for a day. Probably one thing they don't have on Cronus.
I'll bet we have a lot of things they don't have.
That's right. The hypno gun for one thing. If we could just get back to the Athena and get it. Now that we have a good idea where they keep the Seladium.
We've got to get it. But we should find the Seladium first.
I just thought of something. Suppose this food is supposed to affect us in some way, and Azo comes back and finds us all perfectly normal.
He'll know we threw it away.
One of us has to eat it to find out.
But who?
I will.
No, Judy.
Yes, it's best for me to do it in case it's another truth potion. I know less than you do.
She's right, Randy. Don't you see? If you or I eat it and Kradnik asks us questions, we'll give everything away.
I'm already eating it. So it's settled. Tastes sort of like turkey.
You are very brave, Judy. Now to get rid of the rest of it.
How about under that recliner in the corner?
Good. Do you feel anything yet, Judy?
Yes. I'm beginning to get sleepy. It works fast. I just finished eating the last.
She's asleep.
Hadra, quick, Hagor, pretend you're asleep.
Well, well, all fast asleep. Ate every bit, too. Well, that takes care of them until the great Kradnik is ready to interrogate them again. You will learn, my young friends. We Cronians are infinitely smarter than you.
Now, this is our chance, Agor. I'm going to see if I can find that room where the Saladium is kept.
If we could find how to open the panel from the outside, we could both go. Let's try.
Good idea. But we must hurry. We'll have to find the photoelectric beam.
Is it all clear?
Yes, you'd better close the panel and stay inside until I find the beam.
Do you see it?
Wait a minute.
You got it!
Oh, it was pure luck. It's at the base of this right wall, and I happened to intercept it with my foot.
Come on, shut the panel and let's go! Which way?
Let's try this one. I remember seeing an airlift just before you get to the council chamber.
Somebody's coming!
Quick, back to the turnoff we just passed!
He stopped.
He's in the passageway. I'm going to peek around the corner.
He might see you.
I've got to risk it.
Who is it?
No one I've ever seen before. He's got a gray uniform. Must be a Dromo guard.
What's he doing?
Just standing there.
Maybe he's coming to guard our room.
He's gone. He disappeared.
Gone? But I didn't hear anything.
Come on. We've got to find out where he went. Look! Here's where he was standing. Like this.
Randy, look at the wall. It's gone.
No wonder we didn't hear anything. It's an electronic wall and a hidden airlift. Look, I move away and the wall comes back.
We'd better get out of here. If that guard shows up again, he'll be on the top of us before we know it. Come on, come on.
No, Agor, we've got to find out what's down that airlift. It could be the Saladium chamber. Let's go back to the turnoff and watch. If nothing happens, I'm going down.
See anything?
Not yet. Shh!
What is it?
Another Dromo guard just came out. Oh, he's gone. I'll bet anything the Saladium is in a chamber down that airlift. Let's try to find the Athena first. We'll get the Hypnogun, then go after the Saladium.
There's just one problem. We can't escape without Judy. If they catch us with the Hypnogun before she wakes up, we'll lose everything.
But we may not get another chance.
We'll have to make another chance. Remember, they think we're all asleep.
Agor, you've just given me a great idea.
What?
Kradnik told the council he'd interrogate us again. I'm going to try to trick him into taking us to the Athena.
Do you think you can?
It's worth a try. Let's get back to Judy now before someone comes.
Where did you say you found the panel beam?
Down here on the right side. There.
Well, so far we're all right. I sure am glad nobody saw us.
Look, Judy's still asleep.
We could probably do with a little sleep ourselves. Even the old-fashioned kind.
That's true. And we may as well while we're waiting for Kradnik. We should do everything we can to conserve our strength.
Well, our young friends are still sleeping, Azo.
Yes, Gran Shakul. Shall I neutralize the Klingert now?
Yes. We'll get on with the interrogation. What's the trouble?
The neutralizer is not working, Gran Shakul.
Not working?
No. The son of Dr. Hilbro does not wake up.
Well, try the other one. Well?
He does not wake up either.
Strange. What about the girl?
Oh, hello. I had the loveliest dream.
Try the others again, Azo. Are you sure you're applying the antidote correctly?
Sire, I have used the neutralizer all my life.
Oh, Mr. Kradnik, I'd forgotten.
There is something strange here, Azo. Did they eat all the Klingert?
Yes, Gran Shakul, all.
You, Earth Girl, the neutralizer wakened you, but it does not waken your friends.
Well, perhaps if we turn Randy and Hager over on their backs, Mr. Kradnik. Here, let me help you, Mr. Azo. Randy, you'll wake up. Hachira. Hager, Hachira.
What is it, Judy?
Judy.
What happened?
Hachira. Hachira. You see? The neutralizer is working now, Mr. Kradnik.
So I see. How do you explain this, Azo?
I do not know, great Kradnik.
Well, I'll let it pass for now. But I will have the truth before we're through. This minute I wish more information from our young friends.
What information could we give you, Mr. Cradnock, that you have not already learned from the Athena spacecraft's secret computer?
Secret computer?
Yes, sir.
Where is this secret computer?
You have not found it?
No. Where is this secret computer?
It would be impossible to describe how to find it, sir. We would have to show you.
I warn you, if this is a trick, you will regret it.
We have no wish to trick you, Mr. Cradnock. We can never return to Earth, so it's only sensible for us to become loyal Kronians.
Very sensible indeed. Very well. You will both go to the Athena spaceship with me. Azo, keep careful watch over the Earth girl. I am sure they do not wish any harm to come to her.
Yes, Grand Shakul.
Come.
Yes, very Mr. Well, Cradnock.
We will go through this passageway. It is most strange we did not find the secret computer of yours. We inspected the ship quite thoroughly.
It is very small and hidden most cleverly, Mr. Cradnock.
Obviously.
But, sir, nothing is so clever as your bringing us here from the moon.
That is not cleverness, my friend. That is genius.
How was it done, Grand Shakul?
Oh, that is our secret, my young friend.
Azo spoke of an element called Seladium.
Azo says too much. We will go through here.
What a magnificent spaceport, Mr. Cradnock. And your spaceships, are they energized by Seladium?
They are.
But how did you project it all the way from here to the moon to propel our spacecraft and bring us to Cronus?
That is our supreme achievement.
Please, Mr. Cradnock, you are about to learn all the secrets of Earth from our secret computer. Tell us how Seladium is used.
I will tell you only this. Very simply, Seladium produces a certain ray, which activates an element in your propulsion system to generate photon power.
And that ray can be projected through space at the speed of light?
Obviously.
But at such distances, how could you spot the Athena?
By supreme calculation, my young friends. We have received your radio waves for many years. That is how we learned your language. But enough. Here is your Athena. You will show me the secret computer. Where is it?
It is just back here, Mr. Cradnock. Here, behind this panel.
Where? Quickly, I have wasted enough time with you. Where is it?
Why, it is here, Mr. Cradnock. But it's not a secret computer so cleverly hidden. It is the Hypnogun.
Stop! Gods, help!
Don't be alarmed, Mr. Cradnock. The Hypnogun only immobilizes your legs and arms.
Guards!
Calling for your guards will be of no use, Mr. Cradnock, for I shall immobilize them as well. Quick, Hagor, get the magna key from around the Shakul's waist.
Right, Randy.
You can't get away with this.
Do you have the magna key, Hagor?
I have it.
Then let's go. We've got to get back to Judy.
And we've got to find the Seladium before the effects of the Hypnogun wear off.
That's right. If we work fast, we may have a chance. But we can't stand off a whole army with only one Hypnogun. This way. We came down this passage, remember?
Yeah, look. There's the chamber.
Now to open the panel and get Judy.
Oh, Randy, Hagor, you're back.
And we've got the Hypnogun.
Yeah, what are you doing? Where is the Grand Shakul?
Stand back, Judy, while I give Azo a Hypno shot.
What have you done? Stop! I can't move. Right, and you won't for a while.
By then, I hope we'll be far away. Come on, Judy.
Which way?
Down this passageway.
We haven't had a chance to tell you, Judy. We think we know where they keep the Seladium.
Look, the wall has disappeared.
It's an electronic wall, hard as rock until you break the beam.
Hurry, down this airlift.
Oh, this is great.
Like floating, except you get down so fast.
Which way now?
Let's try this one, but be careful. Cradnock and Azo may have aroused the entire population by now.
Listen.
They've sounded the alarm.
We'll be surrounded.
Randy, there's nothing down here. Azo said the chamber is guarded day and night, so it can't be any of these.
You'll have to try the other way. Come on, and be as quiet as you can.
Look, there are two guards in front of that chamber at the end.
It's gotta be it. Hagor, when we get down there, you slide the panel with the magna key while I immobilize the guards.
Right.
Then come on. Let's go. Hurry, Hagor. There'll be more of them after us. Can you find the beam?
Yes, I think I have it. There it goes. It's open. Oh, how beautiful. It's as though the whole chamber was made of gold and precious stones.
Selenium is their most precious possession, and they've put it in their most magnificent chamber.
I've never seen anything like it. It's like being right inside a gigantic diamond.
Do you think that's the Selenium, Randy, in that fantastic box?
It must be.
It's not as big a box as I thought it would be.
Well, remember, there's very little of it. It's extremely rare.
Shall we open it?
Better not. Could be dangerous. See, the box has an aperture here at the end for emitting the activating ray.
Let's take it and get out.
Okay. I've got it. Let's go.
Hey! On the angle! Selenium!
It's the Selenium, all right.
Yes, that's the one word I understood.
Now, back to the Athena. Come on, this way. Run!
Where are we going?
Down this passage to the Spacerdrome. They've got the Athena there. Judy, keep a lookout behind us.
It's not far now.
Careful. It's through here. Hagor, you'd better take the Selenium. I may be pretty busy with the Hypnogun.
Right, Randy. Got it.
Randy, behind us!
Good work, Judy. That was just in time. Here we are. This is the Spacerdrome entry panel. There's the Athena. We'll have to make a run for it.
And there's Kradnuk. He's coming for us.
The hypno shot's worn off. I'll have to give him another.
Randy, they're surrounding us.
When we get to the Athena, get in quick. I'll back in and hold them off.
They're coming so fast. You'll never be able to get them all.
We've got to get to the Athena.
Now's our chance. Come on, now! There's no one between us and the ship. Run for it! Get into the ship, hurry! I'll keep you covered.
What, Judy? We're in, Randy!
Come on!
Okay, I'm in! Shut the hatch! Oh, we've got about 30 seconds to get out of here.
Do you know how to use the Selenium?
Enough to get us going. Hagor, the aperture, and direct the Selenium ray at the Athena propulsion system.
We'll have to break through the Spacerdrome.
Quick, strap yourselves in.
They're shooting their ray guns at us.
Hold on. Here we go.
A reading on the velocity indicator.
It's right up to maximum, like it was when we left the moon.
Good. We should be able to escape Cronus gravity. Check the spaceometer while I get a reading on the altigraph. Judy, feed these figures to the computer.
Right, Randy.
Minus 862 degrees, 0.401 minute.
Velocity 663009.
How does it read?
730-767.27.
Great! This should do it!
That's it! We've done it! We've done it!
I can't believe it! Oh, Hagor, Randy!
Oh, wow, Randy, you were great!
So are you, Hagor, and you, Judy!
We were all great!
Are we really heading back to the moon, Randy?
Yes, the computer puts our trajectory at 18 plus 6. We're traveling the same flight path that took us from the moon to Cronus.
We should be home in a few hours.
And we've got the Selenium.
We've saved the Earth. Just think, we've saved the Earth.